Hey guys, welcome to Protocol Respond. Okay, so in this Flutter tutorial, we will learn about null safety feature in Flutter. Okay, so what is null safety feature? A null safety feature is a secured way of developing Flutter application. Okay, so here I have created a new Flutter project in my Android Studio IDE, and I have just for demonstrating what problem can occur. So I have created some code. It has a string of type name, and I'm just printing the name in a text widget. So what is happening over here is when I print the name, it will give a null pointer exception because the name variable is not been initialized. Okay, so if I do this, it will work, means the name is not null and we can use this anywhere in our app. Okay, so now what I'm doing is I'm just creating a variable and I'm trying to print which is null, and if I do so, it will give me an error. So app is getting installed. So it got installed. Okay, so as you can see, it is showing an error that the data is null and it cannot be null because the string is not nullable. Okay, so this problem can be solved without null safety feature by just adding a question mark and the string that you want to print. Okay, so this if it is null, then it will print hello. So if I run this code now, you can see the hello got printed because the name is null. Okay, so now it is not null, and if I restart our app now, so it will print my name. Okay, so the problem with this is it is not null safety because as you can see, the compiler, the Dart compiler, is not warning us that our name is null. Okay, so as you can see, it is not warning us, means it is not showing any error over here while we are making use of this. Okay, so to make your Flutter project a null safety, so what you need to do is go to pubspecification.yaml file, and in environment tag under SDK, just change the minimum version to 2.12.0 and above, and after doing that, just hit this button, get button. So this will update your minimum SDK to 2.12.0. okay, so now if you go to your main.dart file, so here there is a warning at the string variable that you have created that not nullable instance field must be initialized. So now your Dart compiler will automatically tell you, means it will be null safety, and it will warn you that this variable cannot be null. Okay, so now you can use something like this to solve the not nullable variables. So this is the feature of null safety. Okay, so if in case if you want to set a variable not nullable, means nullable, then what you can do is just you can add a question mark tag just after your data type. Okay, so now if I remove this, it will not warn me any error over here, but it is warning me under this when I'm using this variable, because this variable is null and we cannot make use of null variable to print or perform any action. So to solve this error, what you can do is you can make this variable as late initialization. Okay, so this is just to tell the compiler that in future, at some point of time, you are initializing this variable. Okay, so now if I do this, okay, so even after doing this, it is showing me an error that it can be null. Okay, so to solve this, you need to just add a explanation mark over here. Okay, so now our app is completely null safety feature. So if I run this app now, it will just show me the message. So here is a second example for you. So here I will just create a string by name, first name, which is of type nullable, means it can be null. Okay, and then I will just create a method that will convert this string to lowercase. So in this function I will just print the variable print dot to lowercase. Okay, so here it is showing me an error because we need to add a explanation mark to check if this variable is null or not. Okay, and then if I run this, it will show me an error because we are passing a null and we are trying to convert it to lowercase. That is not possible. Okay, so to prevent this, what I can do is I can just make use of if statement to catch this. If is equal to null, then what I can do is just print a message on the screen for a user. Anything you can print, anything you can update the user about the warning, and then just print a message, and then just you need to pass a return. Okay, so what this will do is it will never give your control to go to this statement. Okay, so this will just return from here to here again. Okay, so now our app is completely with null safety. So I need to just call this function in our init method or anywhere else. So if I run this app now, I need to restart the app. No, it's working. So you can see null found, and this method, this if statement got triggered and this error got printed on the screen. So if I remove this, it will show me an error. Okay, so as you can see, null found, because we are trying to convert this null variable to lowercase. Okay, so I will just undo it. So now what I will do is I will just initialize this to a variable. I will give a value. I will enter the name. It is in capital. So if I run this now, so as you can see, this never got triggered and this print statement got run, and you can see the lowercase word. Okay, so this was the second example. So till now I shown you the manual way of performing null safety. So in this third example I will show you how to convert a normal project, which is not a null safety project, to null safety project by making use of Dart migration. So let's begin. So here I have removed all the code from the previous part. Okay, so here first of all I will just create a Dart file, that is data model. Okay, so I have created a data model which has a string, and the data model accept a constructor. The constructor of the data model accept one parameter, that is name. Okay, so what I will do is for now I will just make it as not required. Okay, so now in our main.dart file, here I will just create an instance of this data model. Okay, and in init state I will just create it. Okay, so now what I have done is I have just created an object and initialized it, but I'm not passing any data to our data model constructor. Okay, so now what I will do is I will just try to print the name which is null, data model dot name. Okay, so if I do it, so as you can see there is no warning being shown in our source code, but when at a runtime, if I run this code, it will give me a null pointer exception that you are using a null in your text widget. Okay, so to prevent this, we need to convert our app to null safety. Okay, so for that, what I will do is I will not do it manually, I will do it automatically. So for that, what you need to do is just go to terminal. And here in command type dot te migrate and just press enter, but note that you need to be a lesser version than 2.12 or else this migration will not work. Okay, so I will just enter now. Okay, so migration has started. Our project is being analyzed by our compiler, so it might take some time. Okay, so migration has been completed. So here is a address by which you can go to it and you can check what all changes that you need to perform. Okay, so here you can see in data model you must add a question mark so that we can make it nullable, and in main.dat file here you must make use of let keyword. The compiler of this dart is automatically showing you what all changes you need to do. Okay, and here in data model you need to do this, and here you need to add a explanation mark. Okay, so there is no need to do all the things by yourself, so this compiler will automatically do it. So just as you can see over here, apply migration, just press on it. It will warn you if you want to take a backup of your project or no, and just press OK. So migration has been applied. So if you go to your project now, you can see the SDK version had automatically changed to 2.12.0, and in data model you can see a question mark has been added so that you can make this variable as nullable, and in main.dat file you can see that let keyword has been added, and the explanation mark has been added. Okay, so this will still give you an error because you cannot print the null. Let me try it. Okay, so you can see you cannot use null still. So you need to pass some data over here. You must change this to required to make use of this. Okay, sorry, you must specify what you need to pass. Okay, for which variable you are initializing the value. So for that, here what I can do is just make use of name and pass the variable. Okay, so now if I run this code, you can see the variable got printed from our data model. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. Hope you got the concept of how to apply the migration and how the null safety pointer works. Okay, so please do subscribe Protocoders Point. Thank you.